Hello guys, my name is Mini Sethi. Today we are going to learn about Lewis model of economic development. This model is given by Arthur Lewis in one article, and article name is Economic Development with Unlimited Supply of Labor in 1954. Okay, according to Lewis, basically a country have a two sector. Okay, according to Lewis, basically any country have a two sector. One is primary, other one is modern sector. Primary sector consists agriculture sector, traditional sector, overpopulated and rural sector. On the other hand, modern sector is high productive industrial sector and urban sector. Okay, according to Lewis, primary sector have a excess supply of labor. What does mean by excess supply of labor? Excess supply of labor means that more person engaged than actually required. Okay, for example, for doing farming in particular field, we actually required 5 person, but whole 20 member of family are engaged in farming activity. Okay, difference between 20 and 5 is 15. This 5 person actually is excess supply of labor. Oh, so okay, you understand, excess supply of labor means more person are working than actually needed. For example, actually we require 5 person, but 20 person engaged in farming activity, and difference between 20 and 5 is 15. Actually these 15 person are excess supply of labor. They are not giving any contribution in production. These person have zero marginal product. Okay, according to Lewis, we should move this excess supply of labor in modern sector. Okay, but how this excess supply of labor will move in modern sector? By attracting by higher wages, because modern sector provide higher wages as compared to agriculture sector. Okay, I just explained introduction of this model. Now we understand whole structure of this model with the help of diagram. Okay, Lewis basically say that in any country have a two sector, one is primary sector or other one is modern sector. Okay, firstly we are talking about primary sector. Okay, primary sector means agriculture sector. Okay, agriculture sector. Okay, we are making one diagram. With the help of diagram, we will understand whole structure of this diagram. Okay, whole structure of this model. In x axis, we are taking number of labor. Okay, on y axis, we are taking total production in agriculture sector. TP represent total production in agriculture sector. Similar, in x axis, we are taking number of labor. In y axis, we are taking MP and AP of labor. MP represent marginal product of labor and AP represent average product of labor. Okay, as we are increasing number of labor in agriculture sector, TP is increasing. We can see that as we are increasing number of labor in agriculture sector, TP of agriculture sector is increasing, but after certain point TP become maximum. After certain point TP become maximum. When TP become maximum, marginal product of labor will zero. Okay, marginal product of labor will zero. This line represent marginal product of labor and this line represent marginal average product of labor. Okay, this line represent marginal product of labor and this line represent average product of labor. Okay, when TP become maximum, marginal product of labor become zero. Okay, in this E point, marginal product of labor is zero. After this E point, if we are hiring labor, they are not giving any contribution in production because MP of these labor is negative. Okay, after this point, if we are recruiting or hiring more labor in farming, in agriculture, they are not giving any contribution in production process because MP of these labor is negative. Okay, so after E point, there is excess supply of labor. Okay, after E point, there is excess supply of labor, means we have more labor than actually needed. Okay, according to Lewis, this excess supply of labor should move in modern sector. Now we will see what happen when excess supply of labor will move in modern sector. Okay, now we are talking about modern sector. Okay, see, in x axis we are taking number of labor, in y axis we are taking total production in manufacture sector. TPM represent total production in manufacture sector. Similar, in x axis we are taking number of labor,
and in y-axis we are taking wear rate that is equal to marginal product. Okay, now when labor start transferring from primary sector to modern sector, we can say that when labor start moving from agriculture sector to modern sector, then what happen in modern sector? See, this is TPM. TPM represent total production in manufacture sector. Okay, as I earlier discussed, manufacture sector provide higher wage rate as comparative to primary sector. Okay, primary sector wage rate is equal to OW. Okay, this OW amount of wage rate is provided by primary sector, but modern sector wage rate is higher than primary sector. Okay, and primary sector wage rate is this one, W1. Okay, this dotted line represent wage rate in agriculture sector, wage rate in agriculture sector, and this red line represent wage rate in modern sector. Okay, this is higher than agriculture sector. Okay, when OL amount of labor is moved from agriculture sector to industrial sector, we can say that modern sector, then TP of modern sector is rising. Okay, and this DD curve represent marginal product of labor, and this DD curve represent marginal product of labor. Modern sector paying wage rate equal to OW1. Okay, listen carefully, modern sector paying wage rate equal to OW1, but marginal product of labor is OD. Okay, means productivity of labor is equal to OD, but modern sector is providing wage rate that is equal to OW1, and gap between OW1 and OD is surplus, or you can say that profit of modern sector. Okay, this is surplus, or you can say that a profit of a modern sector. Gap between OW1 and OD is surplus of modern sector, and modern sector will reinvest the surplus. Okay, modern sector will reinvest their profit. Obviously, when they are reinvesting their profit, investment is increasing, as a result total production also increasing. Now total production TPM 1. Okay, as a result investment increasing, then output also increasing, production increasing. Okay, now more labor is moving from primary sector to modern sector. Okay, now again, now OL1 labor is moved primary sector to modern sector. Okay, now marginal product of labor is DD1. DD1 represent marginal product of labor, but modern sector paying wage rate equal to OW1, and marginal productivity, a marginal product of labor is OD. Okay, OD1. Okay, OW1 is wage rate provided by modern sector, but for a marginal product of labor is OD1. Okay, and difference between OW1 and OD is surplus of modern sector. They will again reinvest their surplus, again production will increase, again more labor will transfer from agriculture sector or primary sector to modern sector. Again, this D2 represent marginal product of labor. Again, gap between W and wage rate is W1, and marginal product of labor is OD2. Gap between OW1 and OD2 is equal to surplus. They again reinvest their surplus. But how long this process will run? This process will run until wage rate in agriculture sector or primary sector will equal to modern sector. Because after certain time period, primary sector will realize more and more labor are moving in modern sector because of higher wage rate. So after certain time period, they will also raise wage rate, and wage rate will equal to manufacture sector and agriculture sector. Okay, this is all about Lewis model of economic development. I think you understood. Thank you.